Bob. Are you Caucasian?
Bob. I want to ask you a question.
Ganesh, you're from what?
Yes, I want to ask you a question.
You're the one asking me questions. Are you Ganesh, right?
Let me ask you a question.
What are the questions? I'm not arguing with that.
Guilty of
your ancestors.
There was a group of people.
No.
Oh, all
he goes around killing nations. He goes around killing nations. He goes around stealing resources.
What are they?
He goes around killing people. Who goes around pillaging? Who goes around raping? Who goes around the country and every time they step up?
Can you have a reasonable conversation? Can you have a reasonable conversation? Are you able to have a reasonable conversation? Brothers and sisters, this is why the black community doesn't need the Hebrew Israelites. Following the doctrines of the Hebrew Israelites just makes you an ignorant buffoon. They shout, they scream, they're unable to have a reasonable discourse. So deal with this devil. Deal with this devil. Deal with this devil. Let me ask you. Let me ask you. Why am I a devil?
Because you're a murderer as a people.
So the brother accuses me of being a murderer. Where is your evidence that I'm a murderer?
Who has killed my ancestors? Show me where.
The Arabs.
The Arabs.
I'm not the Arab.
Are the Arabs the devil men? Are the Arabs devil men? Answer. Hebrew Israelites. Hebrew Israelites. Answer the question. Hebrew Israelites. Answer the question. Are the Arabs?
I'm asking you.
No, I am asking you a question.
No, you asked me first and asked you.
No, you didn't.
I said, are the Arabs devil men?
Yes or no?
What about the murderers?
Are the Arabs devil men?
Are you murderers?
Answer the question.
Are you murderers?
The ignorance of the Hebrew Israelites is that they say that every white person is a devil. That is what they are saying.
That's right. That's right.
That is what they are saying. White people are devils.
That's right. Your ancestors are devils too.
This is the ignorance of the Hebrew Israelites.
Fucking liar, man.
If the African.
My little seat.
Here's the false god. Here's the false god. Here's a false god. Here's a false god. Here's a false god. Here's a false god. Is a false god. Is a false god. Who's Allah?
Allah is a pagan god. Pagan god. Allah is pagan god.
I am forgiven by Jesus Christ.
What did he say? He that leadeth into captivity shall go into captivity. He that killeth with a sword shall not kill you with a sword.
That's everybody. Your ancestors and your ancestors and the ancestors of every single person that's around them. That's everybody. Arabs enslaved people. Arabs killed people. Africans enslaved people. Africans killed people. Chinese people enslaved people. Chinese people killed people. That's everybody.
Are we African?
How long are you African, man?
Because the Hebrew, I want to say this.
What does Africa mean?
The African Caribbean.
You are the devil, man.
The African Caribbean.
You are the devil.
What does Africa mean? You know, not
African. It's a continent.
You stupid.
Derise it.
White man's name, fucking.
Exactly. Exactly. So, as I was saying,
his wife conceived, and the children struggled together within her, and she said, if it be so, why am I thus? And she went to inquire of the Lord, and the Lord said unto her, two nations are in thy womb.
What?
Two nations are in thy womb.
Continue.
And two manner of people shall be separated from the bowels, and the one people shall be stronger than the other.
Yeah.
Than the other people. And the elder shall serve the younger.
Mm-hmm.
And when her days to be delivered were fulfilled,
uh-huh.
Behold, there were twins in her womb.
There were twins what?
In her womb.
Continue.
The first came out red.
The first came out what?
Red.
Came out what?
Red.
Now, just stop there for 1 second. When you say white people are white, when you call white people white, they're not really white. Because if you look at color white, right, for example, right, color white, right? Right. You don't see any man who's white, right?
Go away, bro. Go come
out. There is a false god. There is a false god. False god. Allah is a false god.
Allah is a false god.
Liar. Liar, ya donkey.
My name's not Muhammad. My name's not Muhammad. My name's not Muhammad.
Carry on. Right. Thank you, Akbar.
Thank you. Now,
okay.
Now, in this society today, right, the word white people was coined in 1682. There was no such thing as white people, right? And it, wait, I'm not talking to you. You want to shut up now, right? Okay. Show me white people in this world.
No.
Because if you want to come in, you come in the wrong place, man.
No.
Okay. So there's no such thing as white people. White people was a word to just put you people to put you at the top. Because if you're thinking about white is anything good, beautiful, nice, but are you really beautiful? Are you really good people?
I'm beautiful.
What? Wait.
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah,
it has definition. Beauty has definition.
I got a face okay?
In your own face, you're beautiful. In your own face, you're beautiful. But in the sight of God, no, you are the most ugly people on earth. And I'm going to prove that in the Bible as well. Okay? Wait. You can't apply because I've not finished.
I'm not finished.
Don't mess around with me. I'm not here to mess around.
You're not scaring anyone, okay? Bro.
Neither are you.
Hello.
Okay, but messing around, I don't
I'm
do
not
that.
Shaking.
Okay?
You
I don't do that. I don't mess around with nobody here. Okay? Right, continue reading it.
And the first came out red.
Yeah.
And the first came out red all over like a hairy garment.
So why you suck on white people, you're not white, you're hairy, and you are red. That's what you are. Okay? Laugh like a fool.
And they call his name Esau.
And they call his name what?
Esau.
So when you see any red person on earth, their real name, their real biblical, ancient biblical name is Esau. That's your name. You are not white. God says you are
Esau.
Esau, right?
And they called his name Esau.
Uh-huh. Continue.
And after they came, his brother out, and his hand took hold of Esau's heel.
Uh-huh.
And his name was called Jacob.
And his name was called what?
Jacob.
Okay, now you see, Jacob is not described because Jacob looked exactly like his parents and all the people in the area. So the reason why Jacob is not described is because he looks like everybody. Continue, brother.
And Isaac was three scores years old when she bare them.
Mm-hmm.
And the boys grew.
Go to Genesis 36.
Wait, 1 second. I'm going to reply to that passage. So I challenge the Hebrew Israelites to identify for me where it showed that the Caucasians in the Bible were a particular people. And he went to Genesis 24, reading from verse 21. So, 1 second, 25, fine. 25. However, the one text that he mentioned talked about someone who was red. Do I look red?
No!
This is not red!
This
is not red!
That's not red!
Like a lobster! Ladies and gentlemen!
Hello,
the Hebrew Israelites have failed at the first hurdle! The first hurdle was to identify biblically the Europeans! The problem is that this family they are speaking about was born in the Middle East. And we already know from history that at the time of Jacob and Esau, of Isaac, of Abraham, that there were already people living in Europe. That's a fact. So to try and say that Europeans were descended from Esau contradicts history and abuses the scripture. So far, we have a red man, not a white man, and we have no understanding why he came out red. For all we know, it could be some kind of blood issue. Children come out of the wombs covered in all the liquids of birth. They often come out various different colours. It doesn't mean that they are red. Notice he reads white as red and red as white.
Now let me report to him that.
Into the text. Try again, Hebrew Israelite.
This is what God said about you. Don't tell me 1 second, man.
The question.
Yeah.
My name's not Mohammed. Man, the question.
Right.
Show me in the Bible where the Bible
against the Bible right now.
Identify the Caucasian.
Bible didn't mention the word white. He said the first. Bible didn't mention the first child. There were twins in the woman's womb. Bible never mentioned that the first came out white. It said the first came out red. However, the second son was not described. I told you, if you weren't deaf earlier, I told you that the second child, it wasn't described because it looks like his father and his mother. When you give birth to a dragon, you have to describe the dragon. That's what it did in the Bible. And to even let you know that the child that was born was a dragon. And I'm going to show you in the Bible that the child that was born was a dragon. I'm going to go about 4 verses in the Bible. Okay? One second. I'm going to do 4 verses in the Bible. And go. Go to Obadiah.
Yeah, what? 24, yeah.
That's not what I mean.
Do one at a time.
Okay? Go to the book of Obadiah.
Book of Obadiah.
Now we know that white people, right? When they went to so-called moon, they say the eagle has landed. White people love eagle and dragon. I don't have to look into your camera, bro.
Which white people?
Okay, so-called white people. When I say white people, I know.
Which,
I'm talking about
people?
So-called white people.
Which
okay,
white people?
You say you went to the moon, right? You love going to the mountain as well. You love mountain climbing and all those garbage you do. Now let's read it.
Obadiah love mountain climbing.
Yeah, I do too.
Obadiah 1:1.
When you're talking, I will cut you too.
The vision of Obadiah does say of the Lord God concerning Edom.
Uh-huh. Concerning who?
Edom.
Now another name for Edom is Esau. Okay, continue.
We have heard a rumor from the Lord,
and an
ambassador is sent among the heathen.
Now, just to let you know, this is about the last day. However, we have to identify the devil before the last day. Continue.
Arise ye, and let us rise up against
white. So every nation on earth is going to rise up against white people, so-called white people, because of their crime, because of their genocide of other races. They go around stealing land. Only one people do that in the Bible. Bible describes that. That's one people, right? They go around, they steal, they rape, they murder. When I look at every race, only white people fit that. Everything white people feel, fit what the Bible says. Continue, bro.
Arise ye, and let us rise up against her in battle. Behold, I have made thee small.
Now you white people, they used to respect you. Today you're small. You've been minsky in front of every race, man. Continue, brother.
Behold, I have made thee small among the heathen. Thou art greatly despised.
You're gonna bounce up.
The pride of thine heart had deceived thee.
The most prideful people on earth are the white people. These are people whereby when they genocide your family, they will say we have nothing to apologize about. When they steal your natural resources, they will say, well, we didn't do nothing wrong. You have too many resources, so we just have to come and steal from you. That's only one people do that. Continue, brother.
The pride of thine heart has deceived thee. That thou dwellest in...
You're pushing on me, don't leave me, please.
No, she's not. She's
thou hast dwellest in the cliffs of the rock, whose habitations is high.
Wait. Now, when you say the word Caucasian, Caucasian is in the Bible too. Because the word Caucasian, the etymology of the word Caucasian means cave dweller. What race of people dwell in the cave and call themselves cave dweller? You are the ones Neanderthals, okay? You are the only people who dwell in caves. You love caves. In those days when you used to say Neanderthal, you are the only people who use the skull of your ancestor to drink soup. Go and check your own history. Continue, brother.
In cliffs of the rock.
Cliffs of the rock. So continue.
His habitations is high, that saith in his heart.
Who build skyscrapers everywhere they go when they steal land? Who build New York? The real, let me finish. Don't let me raise my voice again, okay? So, when they came out of their caves, they continued conquering lands and stealing lands and building cities, building skyscrapers. Continue, brother.
That saith in his heart, who shall bring me down
now,
to the ground?
Now, this man has nuclear weapon. He said, who's going to bring me down? Now we have Iran having nuclear weapon. He couldn't say who's going to bring me down. Because your time has an expiry date. You're going down whether you like it, you accept it or not. You're going down, white people. Continue, man.
Thou exalt thyself as the eagle.
So, wait. What did he just say?
Thou exalt thyself as the eagle.
We know that eagle is a very prideful bird. Right? God said, though you exalt yourself as the eagle, when the white man landed on the moon, so-called, he said the what has landed? The eagle has landed. That's right. Only one person that loves eagle. Right. Now you can touch your neck with your finger. I don't care what you do. But if I want to remind you, what is the Roman emblem? Eagle. Spain, eagle. Portugal, eagle. America, eagle. Even lands you colonize, you give them eagle. Wait, I've not finished. Germany, eagle. You are the only people who love eagle. So God says that
we're doomed.
Who colonized Nigeria? Yeah. Who colonized Nigeria? Wait, it's not okay. Who colonized Nigeria? Is it not Britain? Is it not Britain that colonized Nigeria?
We're talking about symbols. You say symbols are the eagle, a white man's symbol. I'm telling you, the Nigerian football club, the symbol is the eagles. They call them the eagles.
Who colonized them? Britain gave them the eagle.
Allow me to reply.
We're not finished.
We're talking about symbols. So finish then.
Okay, I'm going to reply.
Wait, then finish. Finish.
You know you're very unjust. You're very unjust because I will tell you why you say that. When Nigeria, what's it called?
I'm going to reply. So the brother Torquatum Obadiah, chapter 1, verse 1. And in this passage, this is what it says. It says,
stop getting involved. Be the cameraman.
So, thus says the Lord God concerning Edom.
We're not finished.
Edom is a place. Edom is a place.
Among the stars.
It is not a people. It is talking about the region in Northwest Arabia. On the Arabian Peninsula. Now I challenge the Hebrew Israelites to tell me where in the Bible it identifies the Caucasian. The Hebrew Israelites are saying that the Caucasian are people but live in caves. Look around
thieves.
You.
Come to thee.
Do we live in caves?
By night.
No. We do not. And back at the time that this was written, archaeologists have already identified that Caucasians were living in mud huts.
Would they not have
mud huts
they have enough?
And wooden buildings.
That's right. You are the only
they were not
steal.
Living in caves. He talked about eagles. But what about unicorns? What about dragons? What about lions? These are all the symbols of nations in Europe.
The things of Esau?
How are the things of
this kind of ignorance that we see in the Hebrew Israelites will only drag down those that follow it.
Everyone mother on earth is white people.
Those that follow it will become ignorant people. These people don't know Jesus. They don't know the Messiah. They don't know the apostles. They don't know the prophets. They are not part of the church. They are a new religion that was invented in America. That's all they are.
I brought thee even to the border.
So now we're going to bring you to the border, man. We're going to go to war with you. I'm going to destroy you. I'm going to enslave you. You, as you enslave our ancestors. Continue, brother.
The man that was at peace. With thee have deceived thee.
Every nation that are peace with you right now, they're going to deceive you, so-called white people. They're going to bring you to the border and
you
they want
to show me where white people are in the Bible. Where does it say white people in the Bible?
Against you, man.
Where? Show me.
That eat thy bread and bled a woman.
Debate has broken down.
Right? Come down. That's what the Lord said.
There is none understanding in him. Shall I not?
Yeah, you are useless.
Save the Lord. Even destroy the wise men out of Edom.
There you go. What did he say?
Even destroy the wise men out of Edom.
All your wise men are going to be destroyed. All your scientists, all your ministers, all your royal families, they're going to be destroyed.
Where is white people in the Bible?
Out of the mouth.
And you're going to be that day. Where?
Where does it say white people? The Bible.
Esau.
Where does it say?
Esau.
Is that white? That's not white.
And the mighty man.
Esau is not
white. And the
what?
And the mighty man.
Esau was red.
Or the man.
Or the man.
Shall be dismayed.
All your ministry will be dismayed on red.
That day when the Lord
where
came
does that
back,
say white?
Down,
does it say white?
Bring your queen down,
I think the Hebrew Israelites are colorblind.
Every race has here, man. Continue, bro.
Does it say white?
To the end that everyone in the mount of Esau may be cut off by slaughter.
You see the reality.
You are going to be cut off by
slaughter, man.
It's for the
Christian church.
Go to Isaiah 21, Isaiah 14, 21.
No, one minute.
No, it's just going to be. No, you don't want to do that, man. You talk about us, you talk
about him. Let's just go. This is pointless.
Isaiah 14:21. Why are you running away?
Because you haven't shown me where it says white people in the Bible. Where does it say white people in the Bible?
Red people, you don't
know. Red people are white people.
No, they're not white.
That doesn't make any sense.
You want to start again? You want to start again?
That doesn't make any
sense. You want to start again? You want to start again?
Yeah, let's start again.
You want to start again?
Let's start again. Let's start again.
All right,
in this passage.
Wait, one moment. White people are red people, yeah? So, your Bible scriptures are white. His page is white.
Oh, wow. Apparently, my pages are white. This proves
something. Are you white?
You are red.
This proves something.
White and red are totally different things. He is red.
This is red.
Look at his face.
This is red.
He's red.
What color is this? What color is this?
You are red.
What color is this?
Your stripe is white.
Wait, Elk. What color is this? What color is this? What color is this?
We need to grow a brain, eh?
What color is this?
They're on 90%.
What color is this? What color is this?
Bring that, brother.
Isaiah 14.
This is how stupid you will become if you become a Hebrew Israelite. What color is this?
Their fathers.
What color is that?
Prepare slaughter for his children.
What did the Lord say?
Prepare slaughter.
for his children.
The last episode is slaughter for you.
I'm sorry, guys. You're going to have to go. This is just a silly conversation.
For the crime of your fathers. Your father is a genocide. He's a criminal.
Every race and group has committed those crimes.
Not possess the land.
So you're never going to rise again, nor steal land from Australia, nor steal land from America, nor steal land from South Africa. You're never going to rise again. Continue.
Now feel the face of the world with cities.
No, never. You're going to abuse.
Nice try.
What damn devil? Give me.
Better try next time, bro.
Your next time will never come, you damn liars, man. Okay?
You say you're white, but his heart is white. You're closer to the red thing on that thing.
The cause of the world dissolved.
I have a book in my hand.
Our daddy.
Our
daddy.
Yeah, do a quick wrap up, everyone. Bob and Dave, Bob, what are you for interrupting this?
JC should not have got involved in that debate. He should have kept his cool.
Yeah.
Because that ended up triggering and derailing the whole conversation. Pretty however, the Hebrew Israelites, as you can see, are a group that create a fictional history about the world based on a narrative that is constructed out of spurious connections. The idea that the lofty eagle spoken about in Obadiah and the fact that European nations use the eagle as a symbol of their nationhood is such a spurious connection. We know where Edom was. It is a place, not a people. Edom is the place in northwestern Arabia. That's where Edom is. The idea of creating these spurious connections to create a fictional history is designed to cultivate a sense of bitterness amongst members of the black community towards white folk, towards white people. The kind of accusations that were being thrown around are the most ignorant kind of accusations. Yes, white people, Europeans in the past committed crimes. No one who knows any history would deny that. But then every other civilization has committed similar crimes. The Arab slave trade is still going on. The European slave trade has ended. So maybe the Hebrew Israelites need to realize who's still dealing in slaves. The fact is, multiple groups have committed mass murder. This doesn't prove anything, because every one of those groups, if they are going to use this extreme form of analogy to enforce into the text the white man where the white man does not exist, simply destroys any intelligent exegesis of the Bible. And if you're a Hebrew Israelite watching this, I call you to come out of that. You can see the fruits of that religion. It is nothing but hatred, nothing but resentment, nothing but bitterness, nothing but anger, nothing but ignorance. And you can do better. You can do better than the Hebrew Israelites. They will harm your future. They will harm your journey in life, because they will fill your heart with so much anger, you won't be able to progress. Come to something that is life-giving. The teachings of Jesus, the new covenant, is an opening to all peoples from all races. It is a unity that is there for everyone. And it is time that you embrace that. It is something for all peoples to come together in a common identity based on Christ. Not that kind of ignorance and ranting and just butchering the scripture. They have a script that is even more defined than the Dawah script. Yet they literally... They will read out these passages and ignore the rest of the book. They will ignore the rest of the book completely. And I pity them. I pity them, you know? There was no common white identity at the time of Obadiah. There isn't even a common white identity today. So what do we mean when we say the white man? Who are we referring to? The brother seemed confused whether he was referring to white or red. And when I asked him what red looked like, he avoided the question like it was the plague. So I simply say to you, you need to do better, Hebrew Israelites. For your own good, you need to...